Good morning, children. Welcome to my class. And today, our topic of discussion would be articles. And before I start with articles, I hope that all of you have done the letter writing that was given to you for your homework, for your previous day's homework. Okay. Now, let us start with articles. Articles, now, first of all, what is an article? Article belong to a group of demonstratives. Right, now what are demonstratives? Demonstratives are those words which are used before a noun or a pronoun. They are used to qualify a noun or a pronoun. Now, articles can also be classified as demonstrative adjectives because they are used to qualify a noun or a pronoun. Now, articles can be of two kinds, definite articles and indefinite articles. Definite articles are those articles, those words which point out some particular or definite person or thing. The word the is a definite article and a and an are indefinite article. They do not point out any particular or definite person or thing. When I say give me the book, I mean a particular book. Give me the book kept on the table. So I don't want any other book. I want the particular book which is on the table. But when I say give me a book, it can mean any book. Give me the oranges which are in the basket. So I don't want any other oranges. I want those oranges which are in the basket. And give me an orange. It means any orange will do. Okay. Now, uses of A. A is used before a word beginning with a consonant like a book, a tree, etc. Words which begin with a U sound. See, university. It's U. It begins with U, which is a vowel. But what do we say? Yo. Yo, which is not a vowel sound. So, a university, a European, a useful, a unicorn. With all these things, we won't be using an, we would be using a, because the sound for European, university, unicorn, these words, they are yau, which is not a vowel sound. Now here I have made a chart, though I have used a few Bengali alphabets, but that has been done to help you understand the thing in a better way. So I hope you won't mind using one or two Bengali alphabets here. Okay, now see here, a e I o u, we know these are the five vowels, but these vowels have a different sound. A does not sound as a sound as a, like apple, and similarly when we have a in the middle like bat, what do we say? Ba a t. Bag, ba, a. What do you say? Bag, bat. Then, mat. Sad, sa, ad, sad. So, sound of a is a. Sound of e is a. This a. Like when you say egg, engine. Right, and then when you keep e in between, beg, ba, beg, ba, a, g, be, egg, be, egg. So the sound is a. Sound of e is a. Sound of I is e, like igloo. Bin, b I n, ba I n, be in. So sound of I is e. Sound of o is o, like box, box. Sound of U is a, like urn, a. So bun, ba, a, na, ba-an. So we see that the vowels may be a, e, I, o, u, but they sound very differently. A sounds as a, e sounds as a, I sounds as e, o sounds as o, and u sounds as ah. So now children, we know a couple of things about article. We know a and
an are indefinite article which are used before things which are not referred to in particular, and the is definite article we use the when we talk about something in particular. We also learned about the vowel sounds, not the vowel. The vowels we know, we also know that an is used before the words having vowel beginning with vowel sounds, not the vowel. So thus, if we say, say for instance, we are saying an. We are saying an apple. Why? Because it begins with a vowel sound. But again, we say a European because it starts with European. Y-U. Y is not a vowel sound. So though it can start with E, which is a vowel, but since the sound is not a vowel sound, we have to use a with it. A useful. Y-useful. Honorable, honorable. See, H is silent here. So we say honorable, which is O sound. O, honorable. So we use an honorable man, not a honorable man. Or a heir, or an heiress. H is silent. We say what? Heir, H E I R. And it is pronounced as air or H-E-I-R-E-S-S or heiress. So we use an with air or heiress because H is silent. She is an M-A, M dot A. But we pronounce it, when we say M-A, see the beginning sound is M-A, A. So we say an M-A. She is an M-A, but her brother is a BA. My uncle is an MLA. MLA. Sound is A. Send me an SMS. It begins with S. But when you pronounce the alphabet S, see the beginning sound is A, which is a vowel sound. So we say, send me an SMS. My uncle is an MLA. My sister is an MA. But my brother is a BA. Understood? Now we would learn the uses of the. When do we use the? First is, see, there are many things, many places before which we use the. First is, when we before I start, let me again tell you that please write down these things in one place. It will help you to understand the things better. When we refer to a particular person or thing, like I have read the story you are talking about, so I'm not speaking about any story. I'm speaking about particularly about the story about which the other person is talking. I have read a story. It means I have read, and it can be any story. But when I talk about a particular story, then I have to write the story about which you are talking. Next is when a singular common noun is used to indicate the whole class. The dog is a faithful animal. It means what? The dog here represents the whole class of dog. All the dogs are faithful animal. The cow is a useful animal, right? So when I use one common noun to indicate the whole class, then also I have to use the. Next, we use the before the names of rivers, seas and oceans, mountain ranges, group of islands, like rivers like Ganga, the Brahmaputra, the Ganga, the Brahmaputra, the Indus, the Satluj. Then before the names of seas and oceans like the Bay of Bengal, the Arabian Sea, the Pacific Ocean, the Atlantic Ocean, etc. Before the mountain ranges like the Himalayas, the Andes, the Rockies. Before now here you must remember one thing. We have to use the before mountain ranges, but with single peaks. We won't use the. Like, we won't say Mount Everest. We would say Mount Everest or Anaimudi, or we would say when we talk about a single peak in a range, we don't use any article, no the, no a, right? But with mountain ranges we use the. Group of island also we use the, like the Andamans, the Lakshadweep, the Philippines. Countries which consist of a group, like the USA, the Punjab, the UK, okay, and some other places like the Deccan, but with particular region we may use the, but not with all the places. We would never say the India or the Gujarat. We use the with before sacred books like the Ramayana, the Gita, the Upanishads. Okay, now we use the before the names of newspapers like the Telegraph, the Statesman, the Herald, etc. Before well-known building like the Taj Mahal, the Qutub Minar, etc. We use the before celestial objects. Now what are celestial objects? Objects which are part of the sky or the space, like the sun, the sky, the planets, the comets, the meteors, the asteroids, the stars, the moon, etc. Before nationalities or religious group, like the Hindus, the Muslims, the Indians, etc. Before superlatives. Now what are the superlatives? The superlatives are positive, comparative and superlatives. When you say good, it is positive, better, comparison between two, comparative, comparison between more than three, the best. So with superlatives we use he is a quick runner, he is quicker than the other participant, and he is the quickest of all the participants. So before superlatives we use the. Then before the names of trains, ships, aeroplanes also we use the, like the Gitanjali, the seafarer. Okay, now before important events like the French Revolution, the mutiny, these are all important historical events. Here also we have to use the. Before an adverb with comparative, the nearer the bone, the sweeter the meat. The harder you work, the better, perfect you get. Okay, then before directions, the north, the south, the east, the west. To make a proper noun common. Now when I say Kalidas is the Shakespeare of India, what does this mean? So do you think Kalidas has become Shakespeare? No. It means Kalidas has become as popular as Shakespeare in India. Kalidas has become as popular in India as Shakespeare in England. So here I have used Kalidas, right, which is a proper noun, to be Shakespeare. Shakespeare here is a proper noun, but here I have used it to be a common noun. Kalidas has become very popular, or as a very popular man. So I have used Shakespeare in that sense. So here Shakespeare has become the common noun, though it is a proper noun. In these kinds of sentences also we use the before proper noun. Otherwise with proper noun we never say use the. I would not say the Momita is the English teacher, never, right? Or I would never say the John is my favorite student, never. But when I write sentences like this, like I can say what shall the example be, like say Gujarat is the Manchester of India, these kinds of sentences where common noun, proper noun is used as a proper noun, proper noun is used as a common noun, there also I use the. Before numeral adjective, all the students of the fifth class. See, this is adjective. Fifth is an adjective because it is qualifying the noun class. But what kind of adjective? Numeral adjective. So before numeral adjective I use the, otherwise with adjectives, before adjectives I don't use the. But if it is a numeral adjective, I have to use the. Before the word same and after the words both, all and half. This is the same book. Half the applies are, apples are rotten. See, half the. So after half, both, all, we use the, and before the word same also we use the. Before a comparative degree, John is the wiser of the two. So see, we don't use the with all the comparatives, but with few, in few cases you have to use the before the comparatives also. With the names of things typical of their class. Like the example is, the pen is mightier than the sword. See, I don't use the before pens, always before pens. But here, pen serves as a thing which is typical of its class. Like when I say, the pen is mightier than the sword, what does I mean? What do I mean? I mean that writing can bring about greater changes than power, than using power. So I have used pen and sword as symbols of knowledge and power. Knowledge is greater than power. So here pen and sword are typical of their kinds. Right? Now this is all about articles. We also use articles in many other places. I mean, we also use the before many other places. These things will come become better with more of practice, right? And other than that, there is another part left, which is omission of articles. That is where exactly we omit the articles. Now that's all for today, children. In our next class we would continue with the omission of articles and repetition of articles. Thank you.